What's made you decide to stand in this election then, Danny?
Well, I've become concerned. As a local man, I've lived here for 30 years, I've had all my family here. I've really become quite concerned that something's gone wrong with the whole political process. I'll give you an example. The example I'm standing on is real marriage. Marriage is being proposed to be redefined, and that's a big change for a big social institution. But what I've realised is, it's never been in any manifesto. It's never been any mention of it in the coalition agreement. And even recently, the Conservative parliamentary majority couldn't carry it as an idea. So who is doing it? And I think I've realised that democracy has been completely compromised by this elite machine up at Westminster that's taking away all the local life from any politician that goes up there. Whatever they believe, they get stamped on or they get whipped down, as you've seen obviously over the years here as well. So I'm thinking, I won't have a party. I'll see if Eastleigh wants an Eastleigh man to go up to Westminster and be the MP for Eastleigh. Basically, that's why I'm doing it.
What other issues do you see locally that concerns people?
Well, I've been talking to a lot of people, and I must admit, I've learned a lot. The one thing that seems very important to Eastleigh people is immigration. Now, I've been always wanting to walk a quite positive line with immigration, but what I've heard is there's a great fear about what's going to be happening from Eastern Europe soon. And so that's been coming up quite a bit. So I guess I'm aware that I have a clear policy on immigration, which is that I embrace the idea of letting people live here with us, but with clear leadership and control.
How do your views differ from that of the UKIP candidate? Because she said that she's worried about immigration and doesn't support gay marriage too.
Well, that's interesting. The reason I'm not with UKIP is that whilst I agree with them on the EU referendum, and I personally would be saying no, I'm wanting to see if it will change by the time 2017 comes. That's the EU question. But on immigration and on the other ticket that they're standing with regard to marriage, they said to me they couldn't make those, particularly real marriage, they couldn't make it the primary goal of their party. And that's what I'm about, is to say that there's this one thing that's changing everything. And I think that's why I wanted to be quite different. That is my one first thing, real marriage.
With all the economic problems that people are facing, why do you think marriage is such an important issue?
Right, I think because family, it seems to me, where mum and dad raise their children, all the research shows that children grow up most healthily and flourish most greatly in that context. Therefore, the building block of society is the family, and all the jobs and all the other problems that we've got to face, if you've got resilience, or that's what I think the phrase is these days, from family around you that can support you and you're not on your own, would make a massive difference to what's necessary to get through this difficult stage of austerity.
Do you think it's right that churches should be allowed to discriminate against gay people?
Well, I must admit, some people have tried to draw me on that. I'm not anti anything or anti anyone. I suppose what I'm getting, that's what makes me feel uncomfortable, really, because I'm positive for marriage. Now, I'm a Christian, and obviously I think that that's been defined. You know, it's already been defined for a man and a woman. So for me, I'm for that. That's it. I'm for that. I'm not actually against anyone, I promise you. If the people know me, that's the thing that makes me different, I think. 30 years here, people know I'm not a person who is anti anyone. And I know it's a cliche, but I do. As far as I can tell, I think I love everyone.
What's your message for the people of Eastleigh?
My pet message for the people of Eastleigh, vote for me, Danny Stupple, and I will be your voice into Parliament. I will speak for the people, and I promise one thing I can do. I will care, I will care, I will care.
Thank you, Danny.